Let's begin having a look at the available options we have before recording the time-lapse. The ISO sensitivity needs to be adjusted to achieve the desired exposure time in our shots. ISO 100 will give the longer exposure. We can also adjust the light metering mode to select which frame areas are going to determine the exposure. Most typically we will choose matrix metering, the first mode. We are going to record an HDR time-lapse. Therefore, we are going to use the auto-exposure bracketing feature of camera FV-5 in menu button. Above, we have the number of frames to be taken. And below, the compensation step between shots. We can see in the exposure meter the bracketing settings. To dismiss the dialog, tap outside it. Now it's time to set up the intervalometer. It's located next to the bracketing settings we used before. Here we can set the amount of time between shots. Set the total number of shots to be taken. Have in mind that the camera will take 3 times the number of shots specified here, as the auto-exposure bracketing shots 3 photos every time the shutter button is pressed. We are just about to begin, but don't forget to set the focus first. When starting the intervalometer, the focus is not changed, so we have to set it before starting the intervalometer. There are many focus modes, depending on device models. If infinity mode is available, it's sometimes a safe bet in low light conditions, and we have a guarantee that the autofocus system didn't get the focus wrong. Locking the focus is optional, but it avoids accidental focus change during camera operation. Now, let's go back to the intervalometer and just hit start. Now it's time to go for a coffee or read a book while the photos are being taken. At the bottom of the screen, the status of the time-lapse and the remaining time is shown. And that's the result. Amazing, right? Now I'm going to try another time-lapse, this one without bracketing and using long exposure. Let's switch to speed priority mode. We have different presets and long exposures of 1 second, 2 seconds or more. I go for 2 seconds. I select ISO 100 to minimize the noise in the photos. As I locked the focus in the previous time-lapse, now I need to unlock it to refocus the picture as I have moved the camera. Let's go back to the intervalometer and readjust the settings as desired. 2 seconds between shots and 400 shots that playing back at 25 frames per second yield an 8 second long video. And start again. When setting the seconds between shots, it's important to give an extra second for the shutter lag. On newer devices with almost zero shutter lag, that is less of a problem though. And 17 minutes later, and half an hour more of processing at the computer, we come with the result. Impressive. Finally, a last time lapse using a short exposure time. Now I select short preset that ensures a minimum shutter speed of 1/30th of second. Back to the intervalometer. Readjust the setting if needed. Oh, don't forget to focus before running the intervalometer. Camera FV-5 doesn't refocus when tapping start, but leaves the focus at its worst. Okay, finally start. After the time-lapse has finished, we need an external software to build a video from the pictures. There are great open source software out there that will suit the purpose, like AVD Max. hope you enjoy watching. Have fun recording your own time lapses.